Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you are doing well. In this video, we are going to continue with updates of the upstairs. So I mentioned in my last video that we have moved upstairs in terms of renovation progress and updates. And in this video, I would like to specifically focus on the box room. And I also talked about the fact that one of the main things that I don't love about this property is that the main bathroom is basically connected to the box room. And when I bought the property, I tried really hard to reconfigure the layout and think about how I could basically separate the box room from the main bathroom, but it just didn't quite work out. So to remedy this challenge, my plan is basically to install a family bathroom in the loft and then eventually have the current main bathroom and the box room operate as a guest suite. So that's basically the plan. Hello, if you're new here, welcome. I'm in the process of renovating a 3-bed Victorian property in London. And in this video, as mentioned, we're gonna show you how things are progressing with the box room. So one of the really strange things about the box room and the main bathroom is that they both had a massive chimney breast sitting between both rooms. And obviously the family bathroom is really small. The box room, as the name implies, is also really small. So the chimney breast basically needed to come out so that I could maximize the space in both rooms. So in case you don't know, if you do want to remove a chimney breast legally, you do have to get a party wall agreement from your neighbor. The reason is that chimney breasts are really important structural aspects of a property, and a party wall agreement just basically confirms that you have written consent from your neighbor to remove that chimney breast. If you don't want to do that and basically remove it without a party wall agreement, you could be liable to legal action, and ain't nobody got time for that. So I ended up definitely doing things properly and got a party wall agreement in place. You can avoid having to go through a party wall surveyor if you get literally your neighbor to write in writing that they consent. Unfortunately, I had to basically, for this particular neighbor, get a surveyor to review the works, make sure that it was all going to be done properly and above board, and then paid roughly, I think it was £1,500 for the party wall agreement. So yeah, it's not cheap, but it does help cover you in case your neighbor decides to take legal action against you. So you can see in this clip here that the old chimney breast has now been removed, and it took up so much blooming space, it was massive. So I'm going to gain about 20 centimeters in width, which may not sound like a lot, but if you have a small box room and a small bathroom, for me, any small amount of incremental space gained makes a lot of sense. It's also important to mention that when you are removing a chimney breast, you have to have it properly supported, normally through either a steel beam, sometimes called an RSJ, or through gallows brackets. So I had no idea what gallows brackets even were, but basically my architect recommended that was the right way to structurally basically secure the part of the chimney breast that you can't see in the room, because you have to obviously remember that the chimney breast goes all the way up to the roof of the property. So you have to support all of the structure that isn't obviously going to be visible in the room. And in some areas, gallows brackets are now obsolete. In my case, the council basically ended up agreeing that an RSJ would be a bit too excessive, and therefore we went with gallows brackets to support the rest of the chimney breast structure. If you're wondering about how much it costs, the removal of the chimney breast was about £2,000. I live in London, so if you live outside London, it could be cheaper. Always best to get quotes. So in keeping with the ambition to maximize the space in the box room, I also wanted to remove this really strange white box that you can see in this clip here, which basically housed a lot of pipe work. So for whatever reason, the previous owners did a lot of lazy plumbing, so I have no idea why they decided to basically have the pipe work above the floorboards. The main point is that I wanted to have all of the pipe work under the floorboards to again unlock as much space in this room as possible. So that is the update, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for the next video to see how things are progressing. Have a great day and take care. Bye.